In this tutorial, we will perform 3D modeling of this object in AutoCAD 2021. If you want to learn all CAD softwares for free, then please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. As this drawing is in millimeter, therefore click here on this arrow and click on ACAD ISO 3D.DWT and click on custom view and click on parallel. Now here 3D commands are not visible. To activate 3D commands, click here on this arrow near workspace switching and click on 3D modeling. In this object, at first we will create this bottom plate of 96 by 64 size and 16 thickness. Click on rectangle. Specify first corner point. Take your cursor away. Specify length of 96. Press tab. And width of 64. Press enter. Then zoom there. Then to convert this object into 3D, click here on Pressport. Then take your cursor inside this shape and click. Take your cursor above and specify height of 16. Enter. Press escape. Then orbit it. To orbit, press shift, press middle mouse button and drag the mouse. Then next is to create this cut. Here, location of this line is 16 from this line. Then this gap is 16 and location of this center point is 20. Take your cursor to this arrow near extract edges and click on it, then click on copy edges. Then select this line, press enter, specify base point here, then make ortho mode on, take your cursor on this side and specify gap of 16 and enter. Again click on copy, select this edge. Enter, specify base point here, take your cursor on this side and specify distance of 20. Enter, press escape. Then click on offset, specify gap of 16. Enter, select this line, take your cursor on this side and click. Press escape. Zoom there. Then click on this arrow near circle and click on 2 point. Specify first point at this intersection and second point at this intersection. Then to remove unwanted objects, type TR for trim, press enter. Then click on this circle and this line, press escape. Then to cut this portion, click here on press pull, click inside this portion and click on this endpoint, pan it above and click on this endpoint, so it will take that height automatically. Press escape, zoom minus. Then to remove these lines, right click, click on isolate, click on hide objects. Select this object, press enter, then type E, enter, and select these objects, press enter. Then to show that object, right click, click on isolate, click on end object isolation. Then next is to create this plate of 64 by 64 size and 16 thickness. Then one of the easiest way to create any plate is make use of box command. Click on box, then specify first corner point at this end point. Click. Take your cursor on this side, specify thickness of 16, press tab, specify width of 64, enter, take your cursor above and specify height of 64, enter. Now these two objects are separate. To combine them, click here on solid union. Then select this object and this object and press enter. Now they has been combined into single object. Then next is to create this fillet of 48 radius. For that, type fillet and click on fillet edge. Then select this edge, press enter, click on radius, specify radius of 48, enter and enter. Then next is to create this portion. Now here this location has been given as 22. Then this total length is 8 plus 24 plus 8, that is 40. And this height is 28. Click on copy edges. Select this edge. Press enter. Specify this point here. Take your cursor on this side. Specify distance of 22. Press enter. Click on copy. Select this edge. Press enter. Specify this point. Take your cursor on this side and specify gap of 40. Enter. Press escape. Click on press pull. Click inside this shape. Take your cursor above. Specify height of 28 and enter. Press escape. Then next is to create this cut of 24 diameter. Take your cursor to circle, click on this arrow, click on center diameter. Then take your cursor here. Here you can see that surface got highlighted and that cursor gets aligned to that particular surface. Now this is possible because dynamic UCS is on. If at your end this dynamic UCS is not on, then it will not align automatically. Now here dynamic UCS setting is not shown. To view dynamic UCS button here, click here on customization and click on dynamic UCS. Then it will show this dynamic UCS button here. As you can see, it is in blue color, that means it is turned on. So for this object, it is needed that you keep this dynamic UCS on. Now I want to create circle from this midpoint. Now here it is not showing midpoint. To show midpoint, click here on this arrow near object snap and click on midpoint. Click outside. Then click here on this midpoint. Take your cursor away. Specify diameter of 24. Enter. Then to cut this object, click here on press pull, click inside this shape and click on this endpoint. Press escape. Next is to create this rim of 12 thickness. Now this triangle needs to be created on this face. If you want to work on this face, then you will have to use front UCS. Click here and click on front. So here you can see that our XY plane got vertical and is aligned with this plane. Then to hide these grids, click here on grid. Then click on polyline. Click on this endpoint. This endpoint. this endpoint and this endpoint. Press escape. Then to convert this triangle into 3D, click here on extrude. Select this triangle, press enter, take your cursor on this side, specify thickness of 12, press enter. Now these two objects are separate. To combine them, click here on union and select these both the objects, press enter. Then to remove these objects, right click, isolate, hide objects. Select this object, press enter. Then E, enter, select these objects, enter. Right click, isolate, end object isolation. Then to change color of this object, double click on it. Then click here, again click here, click on select color. And from here you can choose your desired color. Click on OK. Press escape. So here this object is ready. If you learn something from this video, then please like this video, and to receive notification for new video every alternate Monday, subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. So thanks for watching. We will stop here.